Docker provides an amazing image storage capabilities that we all can use, but there are some limitations to the Docker registry. First one being the storage. Picture this, you are creating an image which is huge in size and you want to push it securely to somewhere where you have no storage limitations and you have full control over that registry. In this video, we are going to see how we can install and run Quay on a Linux server, which is a registry to build and store container images. We'll be looking into all the aspects of how we can get started with Quay, and we are going to use a free version. All you are going to need for this video is a server, and I strongly recommend that you grab the link from the description where you are going to get $100 60-day credit. Make sure you grab that link from the description and set up your Akamai account so that you can follow along with this video. Let's move on to a computer screen and get started with Quay. So I am inside of my Akamai account. As you can see, I'm going to create a Linode. I'll click on create Linode and let's select CentOS Stream 9 as Linux distribution, and I'm going to select Mumbai as the region, and let's pick a dedicated 16 GB machine so that everything is smooth. But you can also try it out on a shared CPU machine, and you can try it out on a Linode 4 GB machine. It should work, but I strongly recommend that you go for at least Linode 16 GB, because we are going to go for Docker and we are going to install Redis, we are going to install PostgreSQL on the same machine, which is why I am using dedicated 32 GB. Then we can label the Linode, we can have a root password, and let's create this Linode. Now this takes some time, so I'll spend the rest of my time opening a guide which I will provide you in the description, but you can even search it on Google by typing how to build a cloud native private registry with Quay, and this article should pop up. And this is an amazing article because it explains what Red Hat Quay is, and you have all the commands listed step by step for you to get started with Quay. I'm going to follow this guide because it's very handy. Plus, I have all the commands written here. Link to the guide is in the description. Let's open our terminal now. I'll open terminal and I'm going to copy this SSH access command. Let's zoom in so that you can see it clearly. And it is going to take some time for this machine to provision. Let's wait for it and I'll be back. Now, as you can see that this machine is ready, let's try to log into this machine. I'll type yes and I'll type the password to this machine. I hope I'm typing the correct password. Yes, I am. Now let's move on to this guide and let me tell you what we are going to do. So we have a fresh CentOS server. The very first step is to set up that server, set up Docker on that server, set up Postgres, and then we are going to set up Redis on that server. So let's start by installing Docker on CentOS. So I'm going to open this guide. The link to this guide is provided here in this guide. So this is another guide, don't get confused. This is the main guide which we are following. And in this guide is a link to a guide which explains how to install and use Docker on CentOS and Fedora. So let's start. And I'm going to remove the existing installation if it is present, because there is a good chance that an older version of Docker comes with the machine. And if it does, we need to ensure that we remove everything before we start installing Docker. Next step is to install yum utils. So let's copy this command and let's press enter, and we are going to wait for it to install. It takes some time. And after we have installed yum utils, we are going to add this repository. The URL of this repository is here. So let's copy this command. But before that, we need to wait for this command. So you have to put the URL of this repository here. So let's prepare a command. This is the command and this is the URL that we need to supply after the add repo argument. Let's copy this command, and after typing Y enter, we are going to paste this command. So this basically adds this repo. And now we can install Docker by running this command. So let's run this command. It is again going to take some time because it will download and install all these packages. And then we are going to start Docker. And then we are going to enable the Docker service. Let's type Y enter. Let's wait for it. It takes some time, so we'll have to wait. All right, so this has finished. Now we'll start Docker. And then we'll enable Docker and we'll enable containerd as well. So let's run this command and then we'll run this command. And after that, we are going to test Docker installation by running the hello world container. This is a test container that we use to test the installation of Docker. So let's run this and it will pull this hello world container and it will display a hello world message, as you can see. So it says that this message shows that your installation appears to be working correctly, which is great. So the installation works Now we are going to install PostgreSQL. So we have installed Docker. The second thing that we need to install is PostgreSQL, and then we'll install Redis. So don't get confused. This is the primary guide which I'm using once again. And then this is the guide which is used to install PostgreSQL. So let's start with yum update. The steps are very straightforward. So I'll quickly go through all these steps, yum update, and then we are going to install PostgreSQL using yum. And then we are going to set up PostgreSQL and then start PostgreSQL as a service. It is going to take some time. The internet connection inside Linode is really very fast, which is why this is fast. You might experience slower response in your local machine if you're trying this on your local CentOS instance. But again, I'm using Linode and I recommend you use Linode because internet connection is really fast inside Linode. And still it is going to take some time. Let's wait for it. The good part is that it shows ETA as well. All right, so it's running transaction check. And as you can see that it's complete. So let's run the next command. And then we are going to copy the setup script and let's run this command. Now let's start PostgreSQL as a service and then we are going to test this service. So let's start it as a service and let's test whether this service is running or not. And it should show a green signal. And yes, it is showing that it's running. Great. Now PostgreSQL is installed, everything works. Now let's get back to our primary guide and let's install Redis now. I'll close this guide, the one which we use to install PostgreSQL, and we are going to install and configure Redis now. Installing Redis is also straightforward. All you need to do is run these bunch of commands. If you want to know more about Redis, I will leave the links in the description, or you can search about Redis online. Let's add the EPL repository and after that we are going to update yum. So sudo yum update will basically update the package index. Let's copy this command. And after this is done, we are going to paste this command. So we are going to install Redis, y enter. And the next command is to start Redis and enable Redis. So let's start Redis and then enable Redis, which will enable Redis on boot. So whenever your machine is booted, Redis will automatically start. And we really want that. So let's copy this and test. So if I run this command, I should get a capital Pong. And yes, I do. It works. So Redis installation works. Great. Now let's get back to our primary guide and deploy a database. So all we need to do is run PostgreSQL as root. Postgres is running. It couldn't change the directory to /root, but that's fine. Our commands will still run. Let's copy this. And we are going to create a new database. This is going to create a new database for Quay registry. And then we are going to verify that this database is present. Yes, it is present. As you can see here, it is present. Great. Now let's copy this command and we are going to create a new user to use for this QA database. Okay, let's paste this. And as you can see that we have example password as the password. Now let's see if this QA user is present or not. Yes, it is present. Great. All right, now let's copy this command to grant privileges to this Quay user. And then we are going to verify that the correct privileges are at place. So this is simple Postgres. And I hope that you understand how all these commands are working. Even if you don't, you can simply copy these commands and your database will be set and you can still use Quay as your registry. Okay, now you are now connected to database Quay underscore registry as user Postgres. And then we are going to create extension pg underscore tgrm. So this is an extension that we are going to install. And yes, it works. Let's verify that this extension has been installed. And yes, it is. So this was all the steps to set up PostgreSQL for Quay. Now we are going to quit the PostgreSQL shell. And now we are going to open this configuration file where we are going to allow incoming connections. So in order to allow incoming IPv4 connections, we'll have to type host all and this. So let's copy this line and let's search for this line so that we can allow this IPv4 connection. So I'm going to comment out this line and paste this line after this. And let's press Ctrl X, Y and enter. This will save this file. And this is also written in this guide that you need to press Ctrl X followed by Y, then enter to save the file and exit Nano. If you are using Vim, you can go for escape colon WQ. Okay, I hope you understand basics of Linux. Now let's copy this command to open this PostgreSQL configuration file, and we will make some more changes here where we are going to listen to all the addresses. By default it is just localhost, but we are going to listen to all the addresses. So as you can see that listen addresses is equal to localhost. We need to change this to star and Ctrl X Y enter. Alright, so this works. So we'll have to restart PostgreSQL for this changes to take place. Now we are going to open this file so that we can change the configuration for Redis as well. So I've opened this file by pasting this command, and as you can see that we have this bind 127.0.0.1. We need to change it to bind 0.0.0.0 so that we can use Redis from outside the machine. Now when done, Ctrl X Y enter, that's obvious. Ctrl X Y enter, and now the next step is to restart Redis for these changes to take place, and then we are going to confirm that Redis is working. Yes, it is working great. You can check for PostgreSQL also, but it is working, and you can check whether Redis is listening at port 6379, because this is the port which will be configured in Quay for Redis. Okay, now obtain a copy of Quay from quay.io registry. Let's copy this command and we'll pull quay.io/project/quay Quay version 3.9.0. it is pulling it, and once it is pulled we'll run echo inside the container and it should show that Quay is running. So let's wait for it to finish, and yes, Quay is working great. It works. Now we are going to listen to port 8080 inside the container, and we are going to map the machine's port 8080 to the container's port 8080, and we are going to run this configuration file with these parameters. And once you do that, Quay container will start, which you can access from 8080 port on this machine. Okay, let's do that. So we are going to copy this IP address and we are going to paste it here, and then we are going to type colon 8080. You need to enter username as Quay config and password as example underscore password, and we are going to set server configuration. So here we are going to enter the server URL, then database type will be Postgres, and database server is going to be the username. I think it was Quay underscore user. If I'm not wrong, let's check. We have actually created a user. It was Quay underscore registry. So let's type the username and let's type the password as well. It was example password, and the database server host is going to be the machine IP address. I hope this is correct. Yes, it is. And then database name is Quay underscore registry, if I'm not wrong. Yes, this is a database. Okay, so username is Quay underscore, Quay underscore registry. So we have created a user, Quay underscore registry, and the database name is the same. Great. Let's enter the Redis hostname now. It is going to be the same because we are using the same hostname. Now we'll click on validate configuration changes and we'll download this tar file. So we have this tar file which we are going to download. I'll click on keep, and I'm going to open FileZilla to transfer this tar file to my server. So let's log into the server. In order to log into the server, you need to put the IP address here and username is root, and caps lock is on. So username is root and password is the password that you use to create the machine, and then port will be 22 and quick connect. And yes, we are connected to the machine. Now I will transfer this file to /root. The file is this one. Let me transfer it to FileZilla. So I have this Quay config one. Let's stop this process and let's type ls. I have this. I think I have downloaded this in the past, which is why it is showing one here. It should not show in your machine. Let me rename this. Yeah, it looks good now. Alright, so let's get back to the guide, and we are going to create a directory for storage. Let's paste these commands one by one, and then we'll create a directory for config file. So we have created a directory and we have a storage file, a config file, and let's copy this to the config directory. Okay. All right. So we have created a storage directory and a config directory for Quay, and we have copied this tar file to the config directory. Now we are going to cd to this config directory and we are going to unzip this tar file. So let's run this command and let's start the Quay server by running this command. Now after you have run this command, you'll have to wait for some time for this Quay server to start. It takes some time and then you can open port 8080 on your server. I mean on your browser, you can go to your IP address and you can type :8080. Now once you open your server IP :8080, you will be presented with this screen. I'm going to create an account here and I'll say Harry, and then I'll simply put this password and email address. Now I'll create account. Now I'll sign into my account. I'll save this, and now you can create a repository. I have an organization already. You can create organizations, you can create repositories, you can choose whether your repository is private or public, and then you can create a private repo and you can push to this repo. Sky is the limit. You can use Docker login. And if you want to learn more about Quay, the link is in this guide itself. You can go to the Quay documentation and start pulling and pushing your images. Note that your server will now host your images, which means that you have full control and you have full freedom to push as big image as you want. So I hope this guide was helpful and you were able to set up and deploy Quay on your system. Thank you so much guys for watching this video, and I will see you next time.